by the ring strain. Chemists attributes much of the instability of other ring size to ring strain, the increase in energy due to the geometric constraints on the ring. Okay, ring strain can be quantified. Okay, so how to calculate the ring strain, how to say that okay, cyclohexane ring has this much ring strain, how to calculate cyclobutane's ring strain, cyclooctane or like that. So we can calculate this ring strain in terms of heat of combustion. Okay, so ring strain can be quantified using heat of combustion, the energy given off in form of heat during a combustion reaction. That means if we will consume cyclo, if we will if we will heat cyclopentane, cyclohexane or cyclopropane or cyclobutane, then how much amount of heat is eliminating, that means giving off by combustion. Okay, once we will combustion occurs of that particular compound or product, then if that, how much energy is releasing, by measuring that energy we can say okay, this much this component, particular compound, maybe cyclopropane butane, that one is having this much ring strain. It depends upon the delta H0, heat of combustion. Any difference in the heat of combustion per CH2 group for two cyclic alkanes reflects the difference in ring strain per CH2 group. Okay, so if CH2 groups number of CH2 group increases, of course the heat of combustion is also increases. So depending upon the CH2 group, we can say okay, combustion rate of combustion or heat of combustion, we can say okay, this molecule is stable or non-stable. So we will see now in short that how much which molecule shows the how much heat of combustion. Okay, so we'll see one tabular form that how much CH2 groups, which component shows the high heat of combustion. The total ring strain is obtained by multiplying the strain per CH2 group by the number of CH2 groups. Okay, so as you know, all the cycloalkanes contains only CH2 groups. If we will increase the number of CH2 groups, obviously heat of, that means per CH2 group heat of combustion is increasing. So we'll see now how the heat of combustion and what, how, in which way that one is explaining the stability of molecules. Representing one tabular form, now it's not clear clear cut, but still we will refer that one. I didn't find a very precise table. So here I have, here in first column you can see all cycloalkanes up to cyclooctane or cycloheptane is there. Yes, the second column is number of CH2 units per. Cyclopropane has 3 CH2 units, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so heat of combustion, delta is 0 in terms of kilojoule per mole and kilocalorie per mole. Okay, in both terms they have given. So if 3 CH2 units, then kilojoule 1981. As we increase CH2 number, so you can see the heat of combustion is also increasing. For 7 CH2 unit, heat of combustion is high, 4,332 okay, kilojoule per mole. So as we increase the number of CH2 from cyclopropane to cycloheptane, the heat of combustion is also getting increased. Heat of combustion per CH2 unit, per CH2 to that means each and every CH2 unit, how much that each CH2 unit it's utilizing the heat or it's eliminating the heat. Okay, and here in last column, okay, total ring strain relative to the cyclohexane. If you will pay attention here, the cyclohexane ring strain, so 6 point, now here is the cyclohexane, sorry. So here is the cyclohexane. Total ring strain to in cyclohexane is 0. Okay, so 0 is here. And we have to compare all other things, cyclopropane, butane, pentane, cycloheptane with cyclohexane. Okay, so cyclohexane is the standard data for ring strain. Cyclohexane almost it doesn't have any ring strain. It's 0 kilocalorie per mole. And if we will compare other ring strains, so here pay attention at cyclopropane. Cyclopropane showing 27.5 kilocalorie per mole total ring strain. Okay, so cyclobutane having 26.4. Cyclobutane, cyclopentane showing 6.5 or 8.5. It's a little bit blur. And in case of cycloheptane, you can see total ring strain is 6.3. Okay, so all these ring strain they do calculate with the help of this combustion of the CH2 unit. Okay, so how much energy is released from the combustion, and on the basis of that one, they do calculate this ring strain by using all these things. Okay, so there are some calculations. So stability or ring strain we can calculate by the heat of combustion per molecule. Okay, so one more table values regarding this one, heat of combustion. So if we will heat this one, cycloalkanes in presence of moisture or in air, okay, so how the carbon dioxide is eliminating water plus heat, and we have to count this heat, how much heat eliminated, and depends upon that one. So cyclopropane, they have given cyclopentadecane after 15 numbered cycloalkane, they have given the heat of combustion. Maybe a little bit data of this table and previous table a little bit vary, but it's okay. Heat of combustion for cyclohexane, this is standard data, 658.6. okay, so this is cyclohexane as almost strain free, and its heat of combustion per CH2 group is 658.6. that means this is stable molecule. And if we will compare all this stability of this molecule, we have to compare the remaining molecule stability with this 658. So if heat of combustion is higher, 663, 664, so then they are relatively unstable compared to this one. And here after cyclopentadecane, you can find unbranched alkanes. So cyclopentadecane, cyclohexadecane, and all these cyclohexadecane almost it's a strain free like cyclohexane. Okay, so up to cyclopentadecane only there are a little bit ring strain. So here you can see cyclobutane is cyclopropane 697 is also highly strained molecule. Okay, three membered ring, it has highly ring strain. After that 697 is highest ring strain. After that cyclobutane has highest ring strain, 686. Then cyclopentane, it doesn't have a lot. Cyclopentane is little bit nearby to cyclohexane, 662. Cycloheptane also doesn't have. Cyclooctane also doesn't have much. Then nonane, then decane. So if we are going to increase the CH2 group, that means if we are going to increase the carbon numbers, then it's obvious that there is the ring size is getting larger and larger. Obviously, there is no ring strain, nothing. So they are getting ring strain free molecules. Okay, so beyond the I think cyclodecane, we cannot say these molecules they do have ring strain. They are almost ring strain free cycloalkanes. Okay, for next thing we will see the representation of all the cyclopropane, cyclobutane on different conformations of all these molecules.